Hi guys, I'm Sherry from QuantConnect. In this tutorial, we'll introduce alternative data and perform sentiment analysis on Tiingo News Data to trade Apple and Nike stock. You'll learn how to request alternative data sources, calculate sentiment scores for text, aggregate weak signals into strong ones, and emit signals based on those scores. All right, let's get started. All right, so in our first task, let's lay our foundation down to work with alternative data. QuantConnect has a growing library of alternative data you can import into your algorithm. This data covers corporate fundamentals, macroeconomics, news and events, and sentiment data. For this algorithm, we'll be using the algorithm framework to organize our code. And here we can see the Tiingo News API. So one of these alternative data sources is Tiingo News Data for U.S. equities. Tiingo crawls the web for news articles and delivers each article in the form of a Tiingo News object. A Tiingo News object has an article title and a description of the article, along with the companies mentioned in each article. Tiingo's data library contains approximately 8,000 to 12,000 articles from each day since January 1st, 2014. Our first task here is to import the Tiingo News data to the algorithm. Now, there are thousands of different alternative data sources in Lean, so we only want to import the data that we need. You can see how to import any alternative data source in the documentation. For example, we can take a look at Tiingo News imports to see how to tell Python to load this library so we can use it in our algorithm. All right, let's add our statement here. For the next task, we'll add the stocks we want to the algorithm using the manual universe selection model. We can create a new manual universe model and add in two companies here with symbol.create. We want to add the symbols to our manual universe. Okay, so this third task is asking us to write all the scaffolding code for our alpha. It's hard to remember that sometimes, so we can copy the alpha scaffolding from the documentation, like here, and edit it as needed. The alpha model has two primary methods, onSecuritiesChanged and update. So let's add an instance of our new sentiment model. Now we want to create a new sentiment alpha model class with the correct methods. Okay, let's submit and see how we did. Okay, awesome. We just completed our first task. So let's move on to the second one. In this task, we're going to request and use Tiingo News data. Then we'll use a dictionary of word scores and assign a sentiment to each news item. Because the alpha model doesn't know the securities it's going to analyze, we request alternative data for securities in the onSecuritiesChanged method. The onSecuritiesChanged event fires each time we add or remove securities from the data feed. Now, alternative data has two formats, linked and unlinked. When the data is relating to a company, like a news article about Apple, it's a linked data source and must be added with the symbol of the company. Other data sources like GDP and weather are not linked to any specific company, so they're unlinked data sources. So when we're adding linked sources like Tiingo, we want to make sure to use the symbol of the underlying company we're interested in. This linkage is performed by the ticker mentioned in the news article at the time of the publication. Each Tiingo News object represents one news article. Just like other methods of adding securities like add equity and add forex, add data also returns the security object. This isn't tradable like add equity, but provides a unique way of tracking and removing the alternative data source. These two concepts are key to understanding alternative data in QuantConnect. So now let's add to the onSecuritiesChanged method here. All right, now we've requested the data and it will be piped into our algorithm. We can access this data in the slice object using the getHelper method. The getHelper method takes the alternative data type and returns a dictionary. The key is the altData symbol and the values are the altData objects. So task two here says, we want to save off the news data to a local variable. Now that we have the article description, we'll analyze it for sentiment. In this example, we created a dictionary of words we think will appear in our text and assigned the words polarity scores. A polarity score is a way of quantifying sentiment. At the basic level, we can say positive sentiment is 1, negative sentiment is -1. We're going to look at the values in the dictionary that we created, news, and for each article, we're going to get the description and we're going to lowercase the text and split it. Remember to put a space here. And now we're going to assign a word score to a word if the word exists in the word score dictionary. We'll search through our description content, and when it contains words in our dictionary, we'll assign them a sentiment score. First, we'll get the score of each word in the article from our database, which is our self.wordscores dictionary. Then we want to get the sum of all the words in the article, so we can give each article a score. All right, let's submit and see how we did. We passed. Awesome. Let's move on to the next task. So our plan in the next couple of tasks is to save the sentiment score of the last 100 news articles so we can get a sense of the average sentiment. This is because the sentiment of a single article doesn't predict the stock value well. First, let's create a data class named NewsData, which will contain the symbol of the news source and a rolling window of 100 sentiment scores, and we're going to call that self.window. And we want to make sure that the type is float for the rolling window. All right, so we want each symbol to have its own instance of our data class. This means each Nike and Apple symbol should have its own object, which holds the symbol of the news source and the company's rolling window. These are stored in a dictionary news data, indexed by the symbol for easy access. This should be done in the onSecuritiesChanged method, when security subscriptions are added to the universe. Here we'll create an instance of news data for each new symbol. All right, so the news asset here is the security object for the alternative data, and we can access its symbol like other assets under newsasset.symbol. We want to store the news asset symbol here, so later we can tidy up if needed. When security subscriptions leave the universe, we should also remove any associated alternative data. We don't have securities that leave our universe in this particular tutorial. However, it's important to understand how to remove data associated with symbols in a dynamically changing universe. So we can use the remove security method to remove the alternative data as well by giving it the news asset symbol. The news data dictionary is keyed by the company symbol, but its values are using the news asset symbol. So calling remove security here removes the Tiingo News subscription. To remove items from a dictionary, we can use the pop function that returns the matching value from the dictionary and returns none if the symbol isn't found. Let's see how we did. Okay, awesome. We completed our third task. Now on to the last one. Cool. So now we've got a universe together, created the alpha model, requested alternative data, and calculated the scores of each article. We're first asked to get the underlying company and save it to the variable symbol. Linked alternative data related to the US equities is mapped to an underlying tradable symbol. For example, Nike is one of our underlying asset symbols. We'll need that to trade. So let's save a copy now. So for task two, we'll add scores to the rolling window associated with the news data symbol. We can add a score with the window.add method. You need to use the symbol key since this is a dictionary. Now for the last task. We sum up our sentiment scores because a single article isn't a good indicator of sentiment for an entire company. Emitting an insight for each data point might result in a high volume of poor signals. Tiingo News can deliver thousands of articles a day for each company. So let's code for the sum of the sentiment scores from the rolling window. All right, now let's finally emit the insight based on this aggregate sentiment score. We'll predict it will rise for a day if the sentiment is greater than 5. So we used an arbitrary parameter of 5 here for the threshold, but it depends heavily on the word scores above. You might want to explore other ways of classifying and trading on the sentiment. Let's run our last task and see how we did. All right, amazing, and congratulations. You've just passed the Tiingo Sentiment Analysis on Stocks Bootcamp. Thanks so much for joining me in this tutorial, and can't wait to see you next time.